Aaron Donald and Nick Gates. These two had talked about each other in positive fashion. Gates obviously said that he's going up against the best defender he's ever gone up against in Donald. Donald said that he was impressed by how Gates was running this offensive line, but after a half and a few
plays... NFL sideline. Chris Wormley is just minding his business, and then out of nowhere, Isaiah Bugs and Carlos Davis get into it. Wormley gets in between. Mike Tomlin...
Wow. Let's check in. Oh, now we got a fight.
They are going at it. I thought they were joking, but...
That's Wims, Javon Wims. And Janoris Jenkins. With C.J. Gardner-Johnson involved as well, and that was real.
This happened well after the play. I mean, it's over. The play's over.
Whoa.
I don't even know what that was about.
Well, they'll look at that back in New York.
Yeah, he may be gone. He should be gone. The guy who he hit was C.J. Gardner-Johnson, who had nothing to do with that play.
Through the tape. And that is Gardner-Johnson in the face of Anthony Miller. And then just now, Wims...
Well, that's just not smart football. And he can think about it in the locker room, I guess, here shortly.
Try the draw play to Lindsey. A little too quick himself. Tripped himself up.
Damage right behind him. They're tied up and some shoving. And when you go and hit, you throw that punch. I mean, that's it. That's pretty clear, pretty evident. And Rashawn Evans, one of the leaders.
Oh, we got a fight going.
We do indeed. Joyner was covering K.J. Hamler. Bodies have to be tossed aside, and they've got another one, another little fracas.
They had the holding on the play, on Joyner, and then the jab by Abrams, the punch, and there's another punch. And
good kick by Huber. Brand is leveled before he was able to field it. Nick Benogany picks it up and runs out of bounds.
Blood to spill over. If I'm Zach Taylor, I'm taking Mike Thomas out of the game.
There's a fight, James. Yeah. We got a brawl. They're coming off the sidelines from Miami.
You don't want to do that.
Miami's bench has emptied. You can see that the defense ran out there. They were the ones on the sideline. And there are flags all over the field.
22 players, grown men out there that need to keep their cool. And I know that's what the coaches are trying to do as much as they can and manage this, be within earshot of players at the end of every play. Once it gets to the place that we're unfortunately watching right now, though,
you're just looking right up here. They're just battling, and they keep battling way after the whistle.
That's right. It was Deontay Johnson and Marcus Peters.
It was Peters down there.
Little headbutt twice.
There's Judon. Oh. Well, you'll see right there.
Oh. Swung and made contact on the right arm, Gene.
I mean, I don't think it was punt. I think he was trying to get out of contact. The guy was holding him, but it turns out that he did it. So it actually hurts him, right,
and
Gene?
It's a tough position to be in, Tony. You're 100.
22 offensive snaps in the first half.
Tyree Cleveland from the three. And across the 20 to about the 23, and we go down to Jay. And we get a little tussle on the field, Jay. First of all, more than a little tussle. This is
They're going at it.
Yeah.
Broncos have to have some tension like you talked about, Rich. I talked to both head coaches.
Claypool in motion, and he gets the football, and that's a loss. Carl Lawson comes up with a big play for the Bengals. Have to be impressed by this Cincinnati effort here tonight. Yeah, the feistiness that is the rivalry between the Steelers and the Bengals.
Well, nobody wants to hear, if you're a Bengals player, that your record's 2-10. You got no chance in this game. And
whoa. Meanwhile, look at on the sideline here. You got a little scrum. More than a little. The blue shirts have them outnumbered a little bit. Look at Carroll. He's right in the middle of this thing trying to separate everybody. So you've got Gilmore.
I was going to say.
Who's the deepest in there.
You know, Gilmore and DK Metcalf have been going at it all game.
This is what started it, you would think. Well, let's go to Michelle right in front of you.
Of this football game, save one big play over the middle.
Another one big thing, it felt like, for Joe Judge. Things get a little chippy in the middle of the field again. That's how it's been. Some fireworks here at the stadium in the post game. It got a little rough in the middle of things. That was the type of game it was. It was physical. It was chippy.
Second and six. Open at the seven. Smith-Schuster's cross for the touchdown.
Well after the play. On Gregory right in the middle of the field, 94 Dallas. Takes the ball out of the hands from Juju after he had scored a touchdown. Claypool came over and said, hey, you're not supposed to do that. Gregory didn't like a... rookie telling him that, Tony, and
give it to Zach Moss, breaking through, and it's knocked down by DeMarcus Walker to sort out here. So O.J. Mudiah and Davis at the bottom there.
Yeah, this goes all the way back to the last play. His punch is being thrown.
Game right before kickoff, Tennessee has a team meeting out on the 50-yard line, and then look at some of the Titans players looking towards the Baltimore bench. John Harbaugh there with the black baseball cap on and the headset walking out to wolf back. This was the matchup in the divisional round of the playoffs. Coaches Vrabel
out to his right, throws, pass caught, but touchdown Thielen. Jenkins is pleading his case, saying he forced Thielen out before Thielen got it across the goal line, and now the two teams' players start to shove. Well, that was close to no touchdown, but the call on the field is touchdown Vikings.
Chicox, quick handoff to Chris Carson. And some extracurriculars. And that's already Darius Slay and DK Metcalf. And these guys are going to be face-to-face all night. And then some.
And you can just see they're just getting physical, and DK's not going to let it go. This is a guy who is, look, he's a big man out there, and he's trying to establish his territory and let the defensive backs play.
Here's Greg Zuerlein from 34. We get Dallas on the board. 10 seconds left in the half, and players come together. You would expect the Cowboys to be mighty frustrated with the way this first half has gone. But they've been changing the colors, the paint in that locker room all season.
Well, what do you want to be? If you're a Cowboy, what do you want to be? And, yeah, you got all kind of excuses in your back.
Wentz throws, passes, caught. What a beautiful play as Ward is in. And then getting up and drawing a flag.
Try will be attempted from the 1 yard line.
So that moves the ball to the one. And this Philadelphia team, because of that, will be 2 yards short of a first down as he gets six.
Oh, flags came in late.
And now flags as the two teams start to mix it up. That's Mike Evans and Marshawn Lattimore, I believe.
Lattimore is traveling with him, and a lot of conversation between those two over the years. Pushing the back, and then that's the guy they usually get, is the one who retaliates. We'll see how they sort this out.
If the blitz doesn't get there, then the middle of the field is wide open.
Oh, well, they didn't see Ward. You didn't see Ward.
Well, in a year with so much uncertainty, as they untangle a few of the players, including Wilkins and Newton, Flores comes over to and how the football comes out of his hand.
He'll be good.
Yep. Cam Newton is trying to get the last word on it.
This is where you almost just want, you know, it's a first game, it's emotional.
To Shepard, why not? It worked on the touchdown. Oh, doesn't work here as Diggs.
Well, this is not very smart, and the fact that he's laughing, I won't even comment on.
Bridgewater steps up, and down he goes. Flags fly, three of them on the play. Dante Fowler was in there, and now... Now there's a lot of pushing and shoving here. And they're still going at it. And now a fight breaks out. And now finally a flag comes in. Marcus Golden's trying to calm him down. And it just never simmered down.
It was going to be against. It was going to be costly. Here's the end of the play. Pete was thinking he might be tore up as well. That Lockett was, but there they, him and Kirkpatrick are going in. It looks like Kirkpatrick saying that something was said to him, but then he just didn't let it go. The official trick.
I think it started with the awkward way that Lockett was tackled.
Penalty marker is down as the kick is good. Let's see what the flag is. There are Broncos celebrating on the field.
And also a fight.
And Jacksonville inches a little bit closer. Still down eight. And now some jawing and pushing at the end of that play as the officials quickly step in between.
You see Lonnie Johnson and Cam Robinson. Tail of the tape says 6'6", 320 versus 6'2", 213.
I don't think I've ever seen a kicker in the middle of a scrum like that, but Lambeau's a pretty thick dude.
Quick throw, slant, Waller, touchdown! Darren Waller with his third of the year. They got the mismatch and took advantage, and things getting a little bit heated now between these two teams. Gabe Jackson was the one who got tagged with the penalty eventually, and Dominican Sue ended up pulling him out of that scrap. See Carr come over and make sure that...
yards against Steven Nelson right there with DJ Chark. And Nelson was pointing at Chark. Chark was...
team complete to Smith-Schuster, but not enough. Tackled at the 37-yard line. So Steelers, who thought they had a first down in Eagles territory, will punt it away in a nine-point game. So
failed to do it.
Foreman on the carry, showing what he can do. Out of the ball game, and here's what happened. And he takes a swing.
Sack Johnson as he gets rid of this one to Ingram. Evan Ingram trying to make plays with five, six, and seven Ravens around him. And he's going to go down at the 24-yard line.
The 25, the handoff to Smith on first down. Rodney Smith. And now some extracurricular activity, flag thrown.
He's got the block, and as they continue to go, all right, now it's over, right? Defensive guys, we're taught, all right, if a guy is looking like he's going out of bounds, we can't go and hit him. So John Miller has to recognize you're on the sideline, you're out of bounds, it's over.
The change directions, has to go 10. Bills fall on the football, and they will have it. Still a fight for it at the bottom of the pile. Temper starting to flare. See Stephon Diggs right in the middle of things.
One's going to have a big play defensively. And there is a lot going on between these
receivers who delivered it. Let's see.
And he's trying to come in and keep him from scoring, and it's hard to pull up.
Look to be simultaneous. They pick up the flag, so there is no foul. The question is now, is it a touchdown or first and goal?
Here's the handoff. And that was McFarland.
Let's get another update.
27.
Penalty with 9:49. Here it is.
Yeah, and if you're going to fight somebody, somebody other than Sherman, yeah, please.
And the Steelers will pick up the first. Ball came loose after Claypool was ruled down. So a couple of times on this drive, Jonathan, Roethlisberger getting it into the hands of
Russell Gage.
Runner all-out blitz, but Uchenna Nwosu, number 42, is in the coverage. And he makes a really nice play against Evans. Now, he wants the call, doesn't get it. There's some verbal trash that comes from Rayshon Jenkins, and Mike Evans responded. And Evans was the first with the push. That call should go against him.
Penalty only coming out quick. But also, what is happening is Ben Roethlis
across the middle. It is Justin Jefferson fighting for extra yardage. The Bears are going for that football. It's a gain of 12. Fifth catch of the night for Justin Jefferson. The man trying to replace Stephon Diggs.
Just batted down. That was DeForest Buckner who got a hand on it. What a pickup he has been. And now a flag comes in late. We know he's got a fiery temper. And whoever.
Doesn't it feel like? Just feels like that's often how it ends up playing out.
I mean, Golston is, maybe they got the number wrong there, because he seems, yeah, to be the
he seems to be the one holding JPP and Shaquille Barrett back. I don't know if there was anything else that happened in that stretch where the flags were thrown
down, and seven now to keep it on the ground and working his way to set up a third and short is Chris Carson, just shy of the 35 yard.
Starting to see some pushing and shoving because Metcalf is back in action here.
Seattle yet to convert on a third.
Here's Fournette in the backfield. Good penetration that time. Carl Nassib finished it off. It's a loss of a yard. And Ryan Jensen and Jonathan Hankins getting into it a little bit as well.
And that's what Jensen does. He just drives and irritates people. There's the push you last. Look at it. Okay, now I'm going to push.
On the fake, Wentz keeps it and loses the ball. A fumble by Wentz. It got jarred out. And the Ravens have it. Flag is down. Carson Wentz.
And looking sideline, throws it away. Boyd was in the vicinity, but a smart play. Now Byron Jones and Tyler Boyd mixing it up.
And what's happening to Randy Bullock is that play clock is going down. The officiating crew is now throwing a flag, late flag.
First punt today for the Eagles. And Erickson's going to play it from just inside his own 30. Nifty little return. He'll cross out past the 45-yard line. And now we get a couple of late flags thrown at the end. Officials trying to step in. As Templars start to flare, 53 yards in the punt by Johnston, 18 on his
takeover, up by three, and a handoff to Morris. He's up just shy of the 40, a gain of five, and now a flag for more stuff after the play. As he knocks.
They're both winning the Super Bowl this year.
Yeah. I would take that matchup, but it's just not possible.
I tell you what, you can obviously put Kansas City.
Like DK
after the play was over,
comes off the block.
Personal foul. Unnecessary roughness. Number 97, defense. Half the distance to the goal. Automatic first down.
Yeah, late hit there by Malik Jackson, which is a penalty on the offensive line of the Buccaneers. He got hit by his teammate. I think that was Wirfs. And then Jensen comes down and just kind of sticks his helmet.
Ham for a yard. And including putting tuning at center, and there haven't been any mistakes in that area. Oh, a little pin down. That's what that was all about. Littleton. Movement. Pass. Down to about the three. It looked like Kansas City might have jumped. Oh, we got a little scuffle on the far sideline. Adi and Kinley.
Picked off and high-stepping is Mackenzie Alexander for Cincinnati. And flags fly. And there are Steelers in the Bengals bench area.
Ben has thrown the ball into
for Pittsburgh. Usually a high step into the end zone, don't you?
But those 10-plus yard throws, that is not how you produce chunk plays. And as Ben told us, I haven't been playing very well. And so far, he has.
After this is penalty, fourth down. This is number 80's first unsportsmanlike towards disqualification.
Danny Amendola in the face of C.J. Gardner-Johnson after the play.
Arrives with Gruden in 2018. Singletary. First down and long for the Bills. Finally tackled on the play by Mullen, and now the officials have to quickly separate players as tempers starting to flare. Just a couple of Bills offensive linemen at the bottom of that pile, and now multiple flags.
Todd Gurley waits for a block. Not a lot of room as he bounces around and brings an end to the third quarter. We'll scramble afterwards. NFC.
Here is Eckler. Has a nice carry inside the 35 to the 33.
You know, when you watch, there's these two teams that just don't simply like each other. But when you watch tape.
Trying to set up a screen for Jones, I would say that's well covered. A loss of one.
They look like Raheem Nunez-Roquez, the guy we've talked about as far as replacing Vita Vea there in the middle. There's a lot of shoving going on, a lot of talking.
Raheem Hicks got to be careful right there. That's potential ejection. Now, they didn't have him the first game.
Brandon Powell. Some tough hits over there. It's getting a little feisty. Both of these teams, I keep repeating whether it's a punt or a kick.
Chains.
Wow. How do you call that on one or not the
other? He slides. He hesitated. Not good enough for the first. Oh, what a flag comes in. Now the rivalry heats up. Jimmy Ward in the middle of that. Watch the fake here by Russell.
Oh. Personal foul. Defense number 20. The penalties have been. This is the goal. Automatic first down.
The run by Johnson and brought down by Richardson, and around his ankles he finds Myles Garrett and a gain of seven. So he drags him down to the 44. Well, it's fourth down.
Well, and that forces the Browns to use one of their timeouts by handing the ball off. And more scuffling going on in the middle of the field.
Joseph may be on one side, Perriman on the other side. Little discussion here after the holidays to make sure.
He's got a lane. Newton looking for the first down and getting it. And a flag, too, and 15 yards to that one. Isaiah Simmons, who had a personal foul early in the game. It's a huge mistake. On the punch, Donovan Peoples-Jones brings it back six, and we'll check this flag. After saying there were very few penalties, we've had plenty here. Cam Brown was in the middle of it with the Giants on the Brown sideline.
Good patient run for Ito Smith. And they're looking to give him a chance because Todd Gurley, boy, Raheem Morris was so honest. He said, look, he's been disappointing outside the red zone. And it's hard to call runs when if you call two, it's third and nine.
Yeah, eventually you lose confidence in it. And we've
got a little scuffle here.